I want to introduce you to Gary Brown from Amvic. Amvic's been kind enough to partner with us on this project. As we started thinking about resilient design, net zero construction, I thought it was a natural place to show ICF. So Gary, you've been at this a long time. Tell us a little bit about your experience with ICF.
Well, thank you, Gord. I really appreciate to be here today. Amvic basically started our company 20 years ago. We introduced a product that was energy efficient, very easy to use, very strong block and very limited waste. So it's a great energy efficient product and just an ideal product for your for the Cooke cottage.
Thank you. And just Gary, you've been at this a long time. What's been your experience with the product and overall?
ICF is definitely a product that more and more people are looking at today with the need for energy efficiency, with people requiring continuous insulation on the exterior and the interior of a home. ICF makes much more sense. So it really is a product that in today's business in home building and in commercial construction, we see a lot more interest. So it really is a time for ICF, which is great.
We actually do want to show the block and give it a little sense of that. If we wouldn't mind, maybe we could just
sure.
bring that in.
Absolutely, Gord. So this is the Amvic R30 block. Basically, we call it an R30 block because it has an increased size of expanded polystyrene insulation. A standard block goes from 2.5 inch. This is actually 3.25 inch on each side. That in combination with the thermal mass of concrete, the air tightness of the wall, your exterior and interior finish, that's how we get an assembly value of an R30. The block is designed to interlock, so it's very similar to Lego. It interlocks as you stack it up. You brace the wall. You're putting rebar reinforcement in there, so it's a reinforced concrete wall, and then you're placing the concrete in there. Some of the advantages of the block is that the web that holds the two sides together. This also becomes your attachment for your exterior and interior finishes. The web will take 198 pounds of pullout strength, so very similar to wood frame construction.
That's roughly the same as wood.
It is, exactly. So
certainly a screw, though, as opposed to a nail.
It is a screw, yeah. We don't recommend any type of nailing, only a screw, because a nail could shatter it and it also could pull out, so it's definitely a screw. You'll see that the web also is conveniently set up for reinforced rebar, so you don't have to tie it in there. It's in there just fine. So it's really an innovative product that makes life a lot easier for your foundation, for your walls all the way up. And the other advantage in today's environment is it's so energy efficient.
So let's go back to that. You mentioned R30, and the key term there is effective R30.
That's, exactly.
As a building scientist, that's what we talk about. And
exactly.
Just for the folks who are watching, the typical 2x6 wall with an R20, R22 bat, thinking about the studs at 60 inch on center, the actual effect of R-value of that is only R15. That is the total thermal performance. Add a couple of inches of foam to that, R10, which we mentioned earlier, Derek's been doing pretty regularly, you get to roughly an R25, which is a great wall. That's pretty close to where we need it to be from a net zero perspective. And I've been challenging the ICF manufacturers for some time to get past the R22, because frankly, in a net zero context, not enough. Amvic's one of the first, as far as I know, first to do a integrated block without having to do inserts or additional product.
We wanted to do it right. So basically, we invested in new molds.
Got to be expensive.
It is expensive. It's not cheap. But if we want to do it right, you want to get the thermal value of your insulation. With the wood framing, as you know, you've got your wood studs every 16, 24 inch, depending on the on-center there. And then you have thermal bridging with wood framing. So today, it is an advantage to put exterior insulation on. However, ICF is going to give you that exterior, continuous insulation, and interior. So it's a really, really effective way to build a wall today.
So again, I want to go back at that technically, because you said 3.25, 3.25. So that's 6.5 by roughly our 4.2 per inch.
Exactly, yeah.
So that's 24, 25.
Yeah.
And then you get the, it's not the thermal mass of concrete, but concrete, although it's limited, does have some R-value.
It does,
point,
yes.
I think it's 0.083 per inch.
Approximately.
From a net zero perspective. As we move towards 2030, 2032, all net zero, the sweet spot for us is that 28 to 30. You pretty much, you know, we think about solar panels on the roof, trying to make a cost effective. So I really like the fact that Amvic has said, here you go. Mm-hmm. Here's a product that gets you to 2032 under the NetZero program, all in one shot. Don't have to worry about inserts, adding extra product. I thought it was a really nice step forward, and I really appreciate that. It was kind of cool to show it on this project.
Yeah, it really is, and we're really excited about it. The advantage of ICF is that while you still do need to seal everything up, any opening, it does have a natural air tightness just with the concrete and with the expanded polystyrene insulation. Right. So there's going to be relatively little extra effort having to put into an ICF wall compared to a standard wall construction to make it airtight. Thank you.